This video is brought to you by Dollar Shave Club. Hey guys, I'm Nate. Welcome back to the workshop. Today we're going to be trying an experiment that I've wanted to do for quite a while. We're going to use electricity to see if we can engrave or etch steel. Although I think this idea has been done by a lot of people, I got the idea from watching a channel called The Art of Weapons. Check the link below. The basic idea is that you can use a low voltage direct current and a little bit of salt water or vinegar to engrave or etch into steel. We have a few different varieties of this setup that we're gonna try and see which one works the best. I have a couple different types of steel that I wanna try, a flat carbon steel bar and this stainless steel cup. In order to make the designs a little bit more detailed than just drawing with a Q-tip, you can use masks to carefully outline where you want the etching to go. There are a few different types of masks I'm going to try. Electrical tape, nail polish, and a sticker. And then finally, there are two different ways I'm going to try applying the electricity. The first is just using some 9-volt batteries and connecting directly to those. The second source of electricity is this AC to DC adapter, which I'm going to use to let me have a constant stream of electricity straight from the outlet. I've also seen people attempting this using a car battery charger, which should do mostly the same thing as this AC to DC adapter, which is to put out a constant stream of 12-volt electricity at approximately 1 amp. Let's start out by testing our high carbon steel bar. To be sure we have a nice, clean, and non-oxidized surface to work with, let's get some high grit sandpaper and just go over this whole bar. That will remove any oxidation or grease that may be on the surface of the steel. Let's use some electrical tape to mask off the areas that we don't want to engrave. This will adhere closely to the steel, so we shouldn't have to worry about any of the water seeping underneath the tape. There's a line right here that kind of looks like it's exposed steel, but it's actually just the very edge of the electrical tape and it has a little bit of dust on it, so it's white. But in truth, the steel is not exposed right there at all. Now let's take an X-Acto knife and carefully cut out the pattern that we want to engrave onto the steel. All right, I think I've successfully cut out the shape that I want. Now I'll peel off the electrical tape on the inside where I want it engraved. Supposed to sort of be a little flame. Not sure how much it really looks like one, but it'll still work really well for testing. There we go. Got the two cut out. I'm just gonna press down to make sure the tape is really nicely attached, especially these little bits that point down into the shape. I don't want those accidentally peeling off. Now let's just take out one of our batteries and connect it to our alligator clips. Attach our black to the negative terminal and the red one to the positive terminal. These little alligator clips should be available at most hardware stores. I got this set at Harbor Freight for about $3. I have here a small dish with a little bit of water in it. Let's just add some salt. Now we take the lead on our positive terminal and we attach that to the metal. Now let's take a cotton swab, dip it quickly into the salt water, and attach it to the lead on the negative terminal. Our two experiments are going to be with salt water and vinegar to see which one works better. I've heard both can give good results. I can actually hear it doing something. There are tiny, tiny little bubbles forming on this. Oh, and I saw a little wisp of smoke there too. Or steam or something, yeah. Gonna keep painting over it.
You can definitely see the bubbling going on.
Gross. That's all just like etched away steel that has built up on the cotton swab. I'm gonna use the other end of this cotton swab to sort of clean it off a little bit. Then get a new one and keep going over it again. We're just gonna take a quick break and talk about the sponsors for this video, Dollar Shave Club. If you're like me and hate paying the weirdly high prices for men's grooming products, now is a great time to try out Dollar Shave Club. For a limited time, Dollar Shave Club has a really good deal going on for their starter kit for only $5 for new members. This starter kit has their executive razor and 3 trial size versions of their most popular products. Their shave butter, the body wash, and one wipe Charlie's butt wipes. I really like these cartridges that have the 6 blades on the front and the single blade on the back. I've been using these blades for a while and they do a really good job of giving you a nice clean shave and precision grooming lines. To get this offer while it's available, go to dollarshaveclub.com/kingofrandom or click the link in the description below.
All right, that seems to be working pretty well. I'm gonna try it with vinegar on the other one and see if we get any results. Cotton swab, dip it into the vinegar, attach it to the negative lead terminal.
I don't hear anything. With the salt water, it started kind of making a bubbling noise. I'm getting a little bit of discoloration on the cotton swab from where the alligator clip is biting into it, but it's not doing anything on our carbon steel bar. Our carbon steel bar did not seem affected when we tested it with the vinegar, but it seemed to go pretty quickly when we used it with the salt water. Let's take off the tape and check the result. And disconnect alligator clip from my power source. Peel off the tape and see how it looks underneath. All right, so where we had the vinegar, there might be a slight discoloration. You can see the lines going around, but for the most part, that's just where the knife cut through the tape. You can see that it'll just mark it if I don't even have tape there. So we have the outline of where I cut, and it might look a little bit less shiny where I had the vinegar, but I can't tell if it's changed much. However, with the salt water, it really did something very visible. And in fact, there's even a little bit of a lip where the metal has actually been worn away. That is a very, very different look right there. So salt water works great with a 9-volt battery. Vinegar on the carbon steel, not so much. The salt water powered by a 9-volt battery was doing a really good job of engraving the steel. I want to see what happens though if I take a second battery, connect the two together, and then attach the leads to the battery like this. Will the additional power make it engrave faster? Let's find out. Red to the positive terminal, black to the negative terminal. I'm gonna do a slightly simpler design this time. I'm just gonna cut out a square, because a square should test how well it works just as well as a fire. Attach our positive lead to our steel, get a little bit of salt water on our Q-tip, and attach it to the negative lead. Now, using two batteries, let's see how well this works. Certainly seeing something. It's getting the Q-tip dirtier much faster, so I think that means it's working better. Or at least faster. I don't know if faster is necessarily better in this situation, but I feel like it is. My, that was a lot of bubbling action right there. All right, I think that is enough. We can take off our tape and see how it's doing. Clean it off a little bit with another cotton swab here. I would say that is definitely engraved. It's right up to the edges here, and there is a very clear lip where the steel has dropped down. It's a very small amount, I'd say probably a fraction of a millimeter, but it's enough that it can catch the blade very easily. I think I can, even through my gloves, I can feel it with my fingers and fingernails. Well, I would say that two batteries definitely works faster than one battery, which should be no surprise. If one is working, two is gonna have more power running into it. I don't know if it's necessarily a good thing. It does seem to be a little harder to control and give a little bit more of a splotchy result. Maybe I just need to be more careful about moving the cotton swab quickly so it doesn't stay in one place too long. The battery definitely works. Now I want to try moving on to our AC to DC adapter. If you're like me, you might have several of these floating around your house somewhere with no idea what they go to. Or if you don't have any, you can often pick them up at a thrift store for just a couple of bucks. Failing that, they're also available on Amazon. What you want to look out for is one that says that it has an output of 12 volts and 1 amp. This small line with three dots underneath it means it's putting out DC power, not AC power. That's what we want. This end that's on the power cord is not what we want, so let's just snip it off. Now let's separate the two cords and strip back a little bit of the plastic so we have the exposed wire underneath. I believe the wire with the black dotted line running along it is the negative terminal. If it doesn't work very well, then we'll just switch them and see if that helps it. Just gonna fold this a little bit to make it a bit easier for the gator clip to grab onto it. Now let's plug in our adapter. Gonna try a different shape this time. I'm just gonna make a longer, slightly squiggly line. All right. Connect our, what I hope is our positive terminal, to the metal. Our saltwater covered cotton swab connected to the negative terminal. Let's see how this works. Ooh, we got bubbling pretty much right away, which I think confirms that this is in fact the negative terminal. I would say this is a little bit more bubbling action than one 9-volt battery, but less than two, which makes sense since this is 12 volts and each of the batteries is 9 volts. I saw a fair amount of bubbling when I first started applying it like this, but it hasn't been changing the color at all, and there's been no buildup on the tip of the cotton swab. It's been building up where the alligator clip was holding it, but not on the tip of the swab, so I'm wondering if I have my positive and negative terminals switched, So I'm just going to attach the black one to the bar and put the cotton swab in the red clips and then see if it makes a difference.
It's not bubbling as much as it was before, but it's definitely discoloring it more, which I think is the more important look because it means it's actually doing something to the metal. Oh yeah, that's doing a lot more than it was before. So I clearly had my positive and negative terminals switched on that wire. You can see that this time, all of the buildup on the cotton swab is where it's touching the steel and not where the alligator clip is gripping it. Oh, beautiful. Just like how we were getting before, there's definitely an edge on the steel, a lip that can kind of catch the blade. That has removed some steel right up to the line.
Salt water seems to be working great. Both sources of electricity seem to be working great, and electrical tape is making a great mask. I do want to try one other type of masking, and that's nail polish. I'm going to be using black nail polish because it will be easier to see the contrast between where there is and is not a protective coating, but you can use any color you've got available. Our nail polish is dry, so now let's try scratching in some lettering to see if we can use the nail polish as a mask the same way we did the tape.
That started tearing strangely. This is not actually sticking very well to our steel. It's just sort of lifting up in the spots. I was trying to make the letter K, but it didn't stay stuck down very well. It just kind of peeled right off. I'm not sure if this is going to be the best thing to use on our smooth steel surface.
I was supposed to say king with the bit that broke off of the top of the K. It looks more like it says ring, but let's give it a try anyway. All right, I think I've gotten a decent engraving there. Normally I would say get some acetone to clear all of the nail polish off, but coming off so easily that I'm not sure that's necessary.
Here we go, you can definitely see the engraving. It did engrave the metal pretty well, but the nail polish itself just kind of started coming up while I was using it.
I'm not sure if there's a way to make it adhere better to the steel than what I did. I hit it with the very high grit sandpaper, and then I actually washed it off with some isopropyl alcohol before I applied the nail polish. And it was completely dry when I applied it, but it just isn't sticking very much. Maybe it's just not meant to stick to steel very well, or maybe it's just because it's a low cost nail polish. Either way, I think the electrical tape works way better as a mask. If you've tried this and you used nail polish and you had good results, I'd like to know what you did. Tell me about it in the comments. I was thinking I might try a second one, which is why I did two different patches of nail polish, but the first one really didn't impress me, so I think I'm just gonna leave it be and say let's move on to trying our steel cup instead of our steel bar. I have here a stainless steel cup, and I wanna see what happens if I try and engrave onto the outside of it. This could be very useful for personalization in a very permanent way. I also have one other method that I want to try for masking this off. I'm going to be using this King of Random sticker in the same way that I was using the electrical tape. I'm not going to try and cut out every single detail of this logo, but I am going to try to go around the main crown outline and then this one pentagon shape that's touching the crown. We'll see how it works. Now let's just add a little bit of electrical tape along the sides so I don't accidentally engrave anything I don't want to. All right, we've got the mask set up. Now let's try and engrave it. This is a much larger area than I've tested before, so I hope it works out well.
One of the things I'm really looking for is for the surface texture and shine to change. The stainless steel has this brushed look that gives it a little bit of shine, and when we were doing our tests, that shine, a lot of it went away, and I think that was a good sign that it had really engraved down into it a little bit. I think it is definitely losing some of its shininess, wearing down the steel little by little, just what I want.
Now I think I have a pretty good etch into the metal, so I'm going to try switching the leads and using the vinegar to see if I can darken the metal after I've etched it.
Oh, beautiful. I'm just gonna use a little bit of alcohol on a cotton swab and clean it off a little bit. Hopefully it won't completely ruin the finish. There we go, using a combination of both etching methods, one to engrave down into the metal and one to slightly stain it, we've gotten a very good result, I think. The metal is engraved, it is stained, and I'm pretty sure that's gonna be on there just forever. And I'm really looking forward to it. I'm also curious what will happen to it over time, if it will darken or lighten, and we'll just have to see. This has been a really fun experiment, learning how to use electricity to engrave into steel, which is pretty cool. It doesn't take a lot of work. You can easily use a 9-volt battery to make it work, or if you can find one of these AC to DC adapter cords, I think they work even better, and then you have a constant source of electricity that you know isn't gonna drain and run out. We found that using the tape or the sticker works very well as using a mask. I couldn't get good results with nail polish, but maybe you know a secret to make it work a lot better. If you do, let me know. Now, if you have anything metal that you want to permanently mark with a symbol or a logo or a name, you know how to do that yourself. Maybe you have a knife that you want to put your logo on, or you have a steel cup and you want to put your name on it so everyone knows that it's your cup. This cup even came with a steel straw. I suppose you could try engraving your name right onto the straw. Special shout out to the channel Art of Weapons for giving us this idea. Thank you. Thank you guys for joining us for this project today, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then. Here's the pile of the really disgusting looking used cotton swabs. They look like someone was cleaning something terrible with them. If you clean your ears with a cotton swab and it looks like this, see a doctor immediately. Once again, thank you to Dollar Shave Club for sponsoring this video. Go now to dollarshaveclub.com/kingofrandom to get your trial kit for only $5 with free shipping.